Guys, this turned out prettier than I could imagine. An analog display instrument with a retro design. Today I give a few insights how I constructed it, and the best is, I offer the files for 3D printing in the download section. Constructing and 3D printing is really fun. Until now, the analog display instrument only existed virtually in my channel branding. Now it has actually become reality. It's a bit crazy. But you know, maker projects are especially interesting when you're building something that you can't buy. And the goal was to build a decorative casing for an analog gauge. The dial should be easily interchangeable, because I want to use it later for different purposes. I also developed the control electronics for the display instrument. You can easily build it yourself, and by the way, you can learn something about digital filters. I will link you to the videos on the top right. But back to the construction of the casing. While I am technically savvy, I literally had no idea how to design with a CAD program. So I loaded the program FreeCAD, and thanks to some YouTube videos, I learned quickly how to use it. When it came to the design, I was inspired by old moving coil instruments. My design is relatively large, because the device should have a decorative effect. The casing has a diameter of 190 mm. I thought it would be nice if I could build a temperature gauge or a hygrometer in this style. In the past, display instruments of professional systems were that large so that the operator could judge from a distance whether the system was running fine. My construction consists of a base plate for the dial. On the back there is a housing for the electronics and the stepper motor. Between the front cover and the base plate we have a ring as a spacer that presses a disc of acrylic glass against the front cover from behind. This way all parts are held together as soon as you screw the front cover to the base plate. The inner ring is printed from white PLA material, because it is supposed to diffuse the light from our LED lighting so that we get a nice illumination of the dial. By the way, I constructed two rings with different heights. This way I can use a glass disc that is 2 mm thick or 3 mm thick. In both cases, the glass disc must have a diameter of 150 mm to fit perfectly into the front cover. In my case, I used a disc of acrylic glass that is 2 mm thick. It is offered with these dimensions. Yes, it took some thought for the construction. In the end, it's not just about the right dimensions, but also taking certain tolerances into account during design. I mean, after all, the parts should fit into each other. Of course, I was very curious to see if the concept would work the way I thought it would. Obviously, in the end I did everything right, and I can offer you the construction files in the download area. 3D printing would actually have been a hurdle for me too, because I don't yet own a 3D printer myself. But here my nephew supported me perfectly with his know-how and his 3D printer. The printing for the base plate is just starting here. And in this video clip we see the white inner ring, which is almost completely printed at this point. In the next picture, the control electronics and the stepper motor are already installed. Here I have attached a self-printed dial with some tape as a test. You can see here how the LEDs are attached for lighting. I drilled two small holes for the connections of the LEDs through the base plate and glued the LEDs. But beware, you have to attach the LEDs outside the area where the pointer moves. The pointer was printed from white PLA material, and then painted with red color. And here I have to tell you an important trick. My nephew came up with the idea. It's a small detail, but it makes your life much easier. The pointer is placed on the axis of the stepper motor. The pointer's clamping ring has a slot at the back, which results in getting a well-defined clamping force. This allows the pointer to be easily pressed onto the axis, and the transmitted torque is still sufficient to move the pointer. I recommend you to do the same, because the accuracy of the 3D printing is actually not sufficient to realize a hole with a diameter of exactly 1 mm. With that trick, it is not so important whether the size of the hole is exactly right or not. I think this idea is really cool. Yes, there are really good tips on the channel. And that's why I strongly recommend that you subscribe to Electronics Unmasked. And this time you have to thank my nephew for the tip, who also printed all the other parts. All in all, it took more than 24 hours for the printing. And that is quite some time effort, however, the PLA material cost is less than $10. In the next clip, the display instrument has already been assembled as a test. And I would like to briefly show you the effect of the LEDs. I really like the not entirely homogeneous lighting, because it underlines the character of the retro design. Just as a side note, an almost homogeneous illumination could be achieved by realizing the baseplate from white PLA material and then illuminating the display instrument from behind with several LEDs. Maybe you want to try that. Write me in the comments. I'm surprised myself. The display instrument became really beautiful. I might even get my wife's permission to put the thing into the living room. I still have to think about an application for this. Maybe it will be a temperature gauge or a hygrometer. There are very good sensors that can be easily operated with an Arduino board. You can also find examples of the BME280 sensor on electronics.unmasked. So just search for the keyword BME280. And there are really many possibilities for our analog meter to display digital data, or simply an analog voltage. I also find it interesting to transmit data with radio technology or to receive it directly from the internet. I will definitely take a closer look at some of these and post my suggestions. Happy making and see you next time! Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.